No more jail time, no more criminal records. And you know what? This is the will of the people of Indiana. According to a 2018 Ball State Hoosier survey, 78% of us believe that. And actually, according to our own survey that we do internally, this year, that number's closer to 90%. No more jail time. We just don't understand why the Republican legislature and the governor refuse to understand that that's what Hoosiers want. And we are behind the times on this. 12 states, including D.C., are fully legal. Two of them are right next door. 27 states have no criminal penalties. And I point out that one of them, our neighbor, Ohio, did that, now get this, did that in 1975. That was 45 years ago. And the last time I looked, Ohio does not have a history of reefer madness. 23 states have a medical program. Some of those numbers are included in the decrim numbers. But Indiana clearly lags behind, and we are now one of only 14 states that allow only CBD oil. And even then, we danced around that issue so much that our CBD statute is wrong and needs to be fixed. And here's one more thing. Even in the states that have not adopted decrim statewide, several of their big cities have essentially taken that position. Louisville, Milwaukee, New Orleans, Philadelphia, and Indianapolis. We call this press conference because there's still time. Still time to call Chairman Mike Young and ask him to hear Senate Bill 114. Please tell them, no more jail time, no more criminal records for small amounts of possession. The information about where to call will be on the Senate Democrats' social media. And now I'm going to turn this over to my colleague, Senator Greg Taylor.
Thank you, Carrie. Those of you may not know, but recently in Northwest Indiana, a young man traveling from the state of Maine to the state of Illinois was pulled over, and there were small amounts of marijuana found in his possession. That young man had a valid medical marijuana prescription from his home state. Unfortunately for us, he was arrested and put in jail. That scenario should not happen. I have a proposal that would allow amend Indiana's marijuana laws. My Senate Bill 86 would create a defense for possession of medical marijuana for individuals who have a valid medical marijuana card from another state. The bottom line is that sending people to jail with a valid medical marijuana prescription is bad, and Hoosiers should not be paid for their jail time. States and counties around the nation, as already stated by my colleagues, Senator Talia, over 60 locales have done something about their medical and their marijuana, small amounts of possession for medical marijuana. I'm sure that you're familiar with the recent decision of the Indianapolis prosecutor to no longer prosecute simple marijuana possession. This was absolutely a step in the right direction, and the rest of Indiana should follow. What we should not be doing is backtracking from those types of policies. Senator Young's Senate Bill 436 is scheduled for hearing in the Senate Corrections and Criminal Code Committee on Tuesday. His bill would give the Attorney General of the state of Indiana jurisdiction to prosecute any crime that the local prosecutor decides not to pursue. This means that the state of Indiana would trample on the rights of local government and local prosecutors' decision-making power. Indianapolis' new policy on small amounts of marijuana possession is now in jeopardy and is being negated by the Attorney General. Senate Bill 436 requires local counties to reimburse the state for any crime the Attorney General's office decides to prosecute, making locals, people in those jurisdictions, foot the bill for this political agenda. It's now up to Hoosiers to step up. Voice your discontent in regards to Senate Bill 436 and any other regressive proposals that move the state backwards. And let their legislators know that they're ready for change and that they don't support Hoosiers being put in jail for possession of small amounts of marijuana. Call Senator Mike Young and ask him not to hear Senate Bill 436 next Tuesday and ask for a hearing on Senator Italian's bill, Senate Bill 114, and my Senate Bill 86. Thank you.
Questions? Well, my own personal feeling is that simply it's a situation where you've got the majority party in the state of Indiana that's out of touch. Quite frankly, I think they're out of touch with a lot of the members of their own party. Because as was indicated, when you've got survey after survey showing overwhelming 78% of the people of the state of Indiana are in favor of reasonable marijuana reform laws, and particularly the idea that we don't put people in jail now for possession of small amounts of marijuana. There's so many better ways to handle that. I don't know what else to say. They're just simply out of touch with what's going on. We talked about the fact 26 or 27 other states have decriminalized possession. 27 states have decriminalized possession of marijuana. Come on, we're out of step with what's going on with the rest of the nation even. We need, I started out with a little joke about, you know, we're the catch-up state. Well, this is time for us to get modernization in terms of how to deal with this. It's a basic fundamental criminal justice matter. When you hear Senator Talley talk about the fact that it's still the second most common arrest that occurs, where do those arrests end up? They end up in your local county jail. We've got jail overcrowding throughout the state here. So it's something which reasonable people, 78% of the people in the state of Indiana believe it's time for us to reform. Senators, do you have any other comments on that?
Let me just repeat those numbers. 27 states are decrim, but 12 more are fully legal. That makes 39. That's a lot. That is by far the majority of the states. And to go back to your question about why do we keep doing this, you know, that's part of the responsibility and obligation of the minority. If you have to keep on saying it, we've been saying the same thing, not only about this, but about teacher pay. You know, eventually they hear us, and you can tell that by the number of other marijuana bills that are starting to creep in every single year. They are hearing us. They're just not quite ready to do it yet. So we'll keep yelling.
David, you asked a great question. One of the things that's important is to understand that these types of proposals have bipartisan support. I worked on two issues for several years before I ever got into law. I worked on the expungement bill for 6 years before we got a hearing. Now we have one of the best expungement laws in the country. We went from the worst to one of the best. And last but not least, remember the hate crimes discussion? Until something happened, We did not get anything done, but we got something, although far short of what we should have, we got something done eventually on hate crimes. I had that bill for 6 years. We cannot stop pushing these issues, especially when you see that Hoosiers support it just like we do.